This is Warsaw Security Summit online edition. Now we will talk about security industry perspectives, global perspectives. We have now very difficult times for the market caused by COVID-19 pandemic. The global view for this topic has our guest from ANS headquarters in Taiwan. My guest is Israel Gogol, group manager representing SMAC.com, our partner, global B2B news website for the security industry, and part of the ANS group. Hi, Israel. Nice to see you.
Thank you, Mariusz. Nice to see you too.
So tell us, what is the impact for the impact of COVID-19 pandemic on the security industry?
The impact of COVID-19, not just on the security industry, but on all of our lives, is tragic, I would say. It is very big, and the best analogy that I can think of is a war without guns. If you think about it, the situation that the world is in today, now Europe, especially before that Asia, is very similar to war. Borders are closed, businesses are closed, everybody is staying at home, and whenever you open the news, the only thing that you hear is how many people are in hospital, how many people are sick, how many people are dying. And there is a very big impact on all sectors of the economy. So you cannot say that it is a crisis that hits only the banking sector or only the construction sector, or like a natural disaster that might hit the agricultural sector. Everything and everywhere is impacted. And it causes also a chain reaction where more and more businesses just continue to be impacted and fall down. So for example, if you close the borders and you don't have flights, it means that you don't have tourism. If you don't have tourists, then hotels and restaurants start suffering. Then the suppliers of the hotels and the restaurants, the companies that wash the sheets and the towels and supply the food to the restaurants, they begin closing down. And then the logistics companies that take the products from places to places. And because the pandemic is global, any business that has to do with import or export is also impacted. So even, for example, now in Taiwan, things are more or less normal. I can work, but if I want to ship to Poland, there will be nobody on the receiving side to take my shipment. Or if I am waiting for a shipment coming from Poland, it might be stuck somewhere on the way because there is lockdown in Istanbul. So the economic impact is different than any other crisis that we've seen in the recent years. Now, when we ask what is the impact on the security industry itself, the impact is, you can say that you can divide it into three groups. So we have the group of companies that are suffering terribly, just looking how to survive a crisis that no one ever thought that is possible. We have the group of companies that are trying to figure out how to manage with the irregular demand. They're open for 1 month, then there's a second wave, they need to close for another 1 month, and then they reopen, and each time something else is not working, but they are still managing to have more or less normal operations. And there is a small group of companies that for them this is the best time of their lives, especially thermal camera manufacturers. I'm sure that they are smiling and happy, and they cannot meet. Of course, they're not happy that there is a pandemic, but for them it is a boom in orders and in demand. Now, we recently did a survey of our readers. We have global readership from all over the world. A little bit more on Asia side, and the results are that 75% of the security channel players, distributors, integrators, manufacturers are suffering. So they 75% experienced the decline in their economic performance and their sales in the from the beginning of the year until now, and two-thirds, 66%, had to cut down budgets or staff to manage this economic crisis. So the situation is not so good. And what complicates it even more is that there is no clear timeline for recovery. So recovery is different depending on the sector, on the industry, on the country. But if you go through the media and talk to people, you will see that some people say that this pandemic has pushed them 1 year back. Some industry says that it pushed them 3 years back. So all the forecasts for economic recovery are between 3 quarters to 3 years. It makes planning and the horizon for recovery very difficult to predict. So if you ask me how the road to recovery looks like, I think that the best metaphor is a roller coaster. It will go up, it will go down, it will go very, very fast, and it will be full of screaming people.
Okay, so I just wanted to ask you about the forecast, because now the question is, how long will it last? What do you think about that?
Nobody knows. Nobody knows. I can see that now on Asia side, when I talk to our partners in China, in Korea, in Taiwan, manufacturing is going on normally, and life, at least on our side of the world, is more or less normal and resuming to normal activity. So I don't see that there will be problems on the supply side. The major problem will be on the demand side, and like I said, the impact on the supply chain itself. So even if you can get the products and the factory in China, Taiwan, Korea, Vietnam is working normally, to get the equipment from Asia to other countries, especially Western Europe, North America, is becoming more and more difficult. In this sense, this might be an opportunity for local manufacturing in different countries that before could not compete with the Asian manufacturers because of price and because of the availability of a very good and robust supply chain delivering goods from Asia to Western countries. But now this crisis actually gives an opportunity for local manufacturers in other parts of the world to supply the demand in the market. As for how long it will last, nobody knows. So if we look back at the 7-8 months since everything started, the beginning was very, very scary. Then things opened up a bit. Right now, in the month of November, there is a surge again in Europe. And there's no clear answer. If I had one, I would share it with the world. And the nature of this pandemic is also that nobody really knows. So in the beginning, when it started, everybody said that in summer, the heat will kill the virus. Now we are in the beginning of winter, and they say, oh, now is flu season, the cold will kill the virus, or people will stay inside because it's cold, there will be no further infection. So it's very, it's a good, but I don't have the answer.
So we don't have the answer for the question, how long will it last? But the another question is, what's next? What changes should we expect?
Okay, so I think that from what we see as a media covering the security industry, I think that we can expect a few changes on several levels. One is the way that we do business, okay? The way that we do business will change. People are adapting to a new way of doing business, especially using digital means. For example, our video conference right now is an example. People are getting used more and more to using the internet as a way of doing business, of connecting with people. And this is something that I believe will stay with us as we go on, even beyond COVID. So the digitization of sales and marketing and client interactions is something that will definitely continue. And people today rely more and more on digital interaction because there is no face-to-face interaction. This brings two challenges. One, digital is not a replacement for human interaction. It can be nice, but it will not 100% replace the benefits of face-to-face contact and idea exchange that you get in a real meeting. I can give an example from e-learning, online learning. Yes, it is great to have the remote learning when you are in school, but it can only improve good teaching. It will not replace bad teaching. So if you have a bad teacher with Zoom, it will not increase your child's ability to learn faster or to be smart. So the value proposition and the messaging of the company still needs to be strong and to the point in order to be able to take advantage of the digitization because of COVID. A second thing that we can see about how this is the impact of the financial crisis on the security industry. So, like we mentioned earlier, this crisis is cross-border, cross-vertical, and very, very severe. About three-fourths of our readers report that they have a declining revenue this year, and the impact will definitely be on the companies that are in the market and also on how we do business moving on. What do I mean? I predict a very, very big impact on the small and medium companies. The big, rich, established companies will remain big. For them, of course, it is a blow, but they have the resources, they have the deep enough pockets to be able to weather this storm. So, of course, they are suffering, but they're not suffering as much as a small, medium enterprise that suddenly is cut off of the supply chain of orders of clients. So, in the context of the security industry that has been consolidating in the past years and pushing out more and more of the smaller players and relying on a handful of big clients, on a handful of big suppliers, this might make this faster. On the other hand, the fact that now the supply chains, the global supply chains are disrupted, can give a small push or a small benefit to these local players because they are now in the market. So their ability to answer and react faster might give them a little bit more room to be active and capture some market share that before they could not get. Another change that I believe we will see is a change in the economic business models and how companies like to work. Clients, buyers, people that buy security equipment will also have a hard time in the coming year once we move out of COVID. So their budgets will also go down. So the inclination or the ability to put up a large amount of money for a new project will diminish. So I also think that we will see a change of moving from a CapEx model to an OpEx model. More and more companies will try to move to an operating expenses business model where they rent or buy a subscription according to their needs and not invest a lot of money in big systems and big projects. This is on the business side, how we do business. From the technology side, I think that COVID-19 also gave a big push to a few things. Like I said before, digitization. So more and more companies will adopt doing things online. Even if companies that before relied on salespeople going, knocking on door, having a lot of face-to-face meetings, will now definitely see the need in investing in having an online offering, not just marketing materials and information, but also a way how to receive orders, take care of fulfillment, sending out things. In terms of technical features, I believe that COVID-19 will give cloud systems a very, very big push. The ability to remotely manage deployments of security systems, to update cameras in many, many different sites, to remote view different locations, especially now when there is lockdown and you cannot send somebody to the site to fix it, or you cannot send people to sit and monitor from a certain site, cloud becomes a viable solution, something that you can use and I believe will be pushed furthermore. The other thing that we see in terms of the features are features that are already there, but now become more popular or are repackaged in a way that makes them COVID ready. For example, contactless solutions for access control is something that already exists in the market, but now people are more interested in it because they don't want to touch things, not to get a virus. Remote viewing is something that already existing for several years, but now that people are closed at home and they need to find a way to look and monitor their store or their business, it is another feature that is growing in importance. And in the past few months, companies are rolling out repackaged features to help fight COVID-19. So if before you used video analytics to count how many people you have, you say it's for contact tracing and to make sure that people keep social distancing between themselves, or to detect masks. So these are already existing features that are now being repackaged and introduced to the market to help manage COVID-19.
So according to the security market, the conclusion is that pandemic will rebuild the security industry structure, right?
The security industry is not going anywhere. The need for security will always be there, and the need to answer the demands of clients when there is a crisis will still be there. So the pandemic will definitely impact how security companies do business, and it will definitely push it in a few ways. Me personally, I believe that the cloud technology will get a very significant push, and that we will see much more online interactions between buyers and sellers. So these are the two main changes that I see coming in the near future. But the ability of the security industry to solve problems for clients, to help them with their resiliency, with their backup plan. So if, for example, you have a store or you have a factory and you have to close it because of COVID, you still need to make sure that it doesn't burn when you're away. You still need to make sure that there's no vandalism, that there's no robbery, that there are no any other things that might impact your business. So I don't see a big impact in our value proposition, the security industry's value proposition. The big difficulty will be the economic constraints. If clients do not have money and do not build new houses, new projects, new factories, then of course there will be less demand for products. In that sense, the security industry is linked to the rest of the economy. So, of course, if you are a seller of security solutions, but all your buyers are sitting at home in lockdown and don't know when they will have budget for the next project, they will not buy from you. Even though they recognize that your ability to help them is there and that you can help.
Thank you, Israel, for your global view of the market, and thank you for your time.
It was my pleasure. Thank you so much.